Hey, folks. Welcome, welcome. Here we go. Another week. This is the Arizona Live Music Cooperative. We're going to get started with a Groove Source jazz duo who you see on stage. They're here for the first time. That's going to be Rick Smith and Diane Elrod, and I think she's here for the first time. And Mark Bishop Evans, he's here for the 175th time. And Mark Nowicki, he was born here. The Groove Source Jazz Duo.
Hello, everybody. How you doing this afternoon? We're so happy to be here. We are going to start out with a tune that was written by Peggy Lee, who is one of the great vocalists of her day. And also this tune was recorded by Diana Krall. It's called I Love Being Here With You. But I only love to go there as a guest, 'cause I love being here with you. I love the sea, I love the shore, I love the rocks, and what is more, you and they never be a bore, 'cause I love being here with you. Singing in the shower, laughing by the hour, life is such a breezy game. I love all kinds of weather, long as we're together. Oh, I love to hear you say my name. I love good wine, fine cuisine, candlelight. I love the scene, but baby, if you know just what I mean, I love being here with you. Thank you. Okay, now we're going to do a samba, which is kind of unique on its own. This is called the one-note samba.
Talk and just say no.
So I come back to this first note, as I must come back to you. I will pour into that one note all the love I feel for you. Anyone who wants a whole show, re mi fa sol la ti do, they will find themselves with no show. Better play the note you know.
Much.
You guys sound great. That is the Groove Source Jazz Duo.
Thanks, folks.
Are you local folks?
We are. We're local.
Yeah. Not snowbirds or anything?
No, we live here in Phoenix.
All right. Well, come back.
We will definitely.
Yeah. If you were a snowbird, we wouldn't invite you back. But, you know, we'd say it's time for you to go.
Right.
Wherever. Thank you so much. You guys sound wonderful.
Thank you so much.
Wow. That was great. One more time for these guys. That was great. Fantastic. All right. It's Rick Smith.
Thank you very much. Not happy about having to follow that act, but we'll do the best we can. We'll give it a shot. All right. Ouch. All right. This is a song by Jim Croce. Called Age. I've been up and down and around and round and back again. Been so many places I don't remember where or when. And my only boss was the clock on the wall and my only friend. Never really was a friend at all. I've traded love for pennies, sold my soul for less. Lost my ideals in that long tunnel of time. I've turned inside out and around about and back and then found myself right back where I started again. Once I had myself a million, now I've only got a dime. The difference don't seem quite as bad today. With a nickel or a million, I was searching all the time. Something that I'd never lost or left behind. I've traded love for pennies, sold my soul for less. Lost my ideals in that long tunnel of time. I've turned inside out and around about and back and then found myself right back where I started again. Second circle, and I'm headed for the top. I've learned a lot of things along the way. I'll be careful while I'm climbing, 'cause it hurts a lot to drop. And when you're down, nobody gives a damn anyway. I've traded love for pennies, sold my soul for less. Lost my ideals in that long tunnel of time. I've been inside out and around about and back, and then found myself right back where I started again. Thank you very much. That's Jim Croce. This next song is a song by Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. There it is. It's called Into the Great Wide Open.
Out in the
Thank you very much. Rick Smith, folks. That sounded really nice, Rick. Thank you so much for bringing those songs. I always love hearing some Tom Petty. All right. Where you been hiding all these weeks and years?
It's a long drive from Goodyear.
That sounds like a country song. It's a long drive from Goodyear.
I should write a song about that.
A long, dusty drive from Goodyear. Well, I'm glad you're here from Goodyear or wherever. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Diane to the Arizona Live Music Cooperative.
You know, and I did go to Purdue, so I really should be watching the game. But, oh, that was many, many, many years ago. So I don't know if you noticed my shirt here. It's from, I got it in Wickenburg, and they have an art exhibit there periodically called Cowgirl Up. And it features women artists who paint Western scenes. And so I thought, wouldn't that be a good title for a song, Cowgirl Up? So this is what I wrote. Hey, hey, cowgirl, it's time to cowgirl up. Rodeo bound and hoping for a prize. Falling down, got stardust in your eyes. Get back upon that saddle, you're in for better luck. With the help from Grace and girlfriends, it's time to cowgirl up. Cowgirl up. This is another song that I wrote inspired by Lord of the Rings. And it's the it's one of the final scenes where Frodo is sailing off on with Gandalf and some of the elves. And then poor Sam is waiting behind saying goodbye to his friend after all of the adventures. Shadows o'er the land, with swords of elves and wizards, we took the final stand. Destiny and glory, eagles sing. day. Magic trees embracing, lifting us away.
Nicely done. That's Diane all the way from Goodyear. All right. Wonderful. Thanks for coming by and hope you come on back. Thank you, Diane. That was nice. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. It's Mark Bishop Evans.
At last the purple dust of twilight time steals across the meadows of my heart, and high up in the sky the little stars climb, reminding me that we're apart. You wander down the lane and far away, leaving me a song that will not die. And love is now the stardust of yesterday, the music of the years gone by. Sometimes I wonder why I spend the lonely nights dreaming of a song. The melody haunts my reverie, and I am once again with you, and our love was new, and each kiss an inspiration. But that was long ago. Now my consolation is in the stardust of a song beside the garden wall, when stars were bright and you were in my arms. Nightingale tells his fairy tale, paradise roses bloom. And though I dream in vain, in my heart there always will remain my stardust melody, the memory of love's refrain. Oh, and our love was new. And each kiss an inspiration. That was long ago. Now my consolation is in the stardust of a song. Beside the garden wall, when stars were bright and you were in my arms, the nightingale tells his fairy tale in paradise where roses bloom. And though I dream in vain, in my heart they're always. My stardust melody, the memory of love's refrain.
Yeah. Nat King Cole made that one a huge back in the day. And actually, Johnny Mathis did this next song, and Ray Conniff's orchestra backed him up on that. So this one is called When Sunny Gets Blue. Sunny gets blue, her eyes get gray and cloudy, then the rain begins to fall. Pitter-patter, pitter-patter, love has gone, so what can matter? No sweet love of man. Sunny gets blue, she breathes a sigh of sadness, like the winds that stir the trees. Winds that start those leaves to swaying, like some violin that keep playing, weird and haunting melody. How she got her name. But since that sad affair, well, she lost a smile and she's changed her style. Somehow she's not the same. Oh, but memories will fade and her pretty dreams will rise up where her other dreams, they all fell through. Hurry, new love, hurry near. Kiss away each lonely tear and hold her near when sunny gets blue. People used to love to hear her laugh and to see her smile. That's how she got her name. But since that sad affair, oh, she's lost her smile, changed her style. Somehow she's not the same. Oh, but memories gonna fade, and her pretty dreams will rise up where those old dreams, they all fell through. Hurry, new love, hurry near. Kiss away his lonely tear. Hold her near when sunny gets blue. You gotta hold her near. You got to hold her near. You've got to hold her near when sunny. Thank you.
That's Mark Bishop Evans. Hey, folks, it's Mark Nowicki.
I'm just going to play some stuff. I was just down in Tucson, at the festival last week. That's pretty darn good. So you guys should get there at some point. It's really good. And that's all I know. Blues. I don't know. It's just fun. lost in the beginning there. When I don't do my blues stuff, I get all messed up, so I have to go to that so I can relax.
It sounded great. Mark Nowicki, folks, with the blues and stuff. Okay. I love it. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Peter to the microphone.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Clouds all disappear. Angie, Angie, where will it lead us from here? With no loving in our souls and no money in our clothes, but you can't say we're satisfied. Angie, you can't say we never tried. Angie, you're beautiful, yeah, but ain't it time we said goodbye? Angie, I still love you, baby. Remember all those nights we cried. All the dreams we held so close seem to all go up in smoke. Let me whisper in your ear. Angie, Angie, where will it lead us from here? Oh, Angie, don't you weep. All your kisses still taste sweet. I hate the sadness in your eyes. But Angie, Angie, ain't it time we said goodbye? Loving in our souls and no money in our clothes, you can't say we're satisfied. But Angie, I still love you, baby. Everywhere I look, I see your eyes. There ain't a woman that comes close to you. Well, come on, baby, dry your eyes. But Angie, good to be alive. Angie, Angie, they can't say we never try.
Thank you. Tell the bad brother he owes me $5 for that song. All right, went to the Stones, now we'll try the Beatles.
Something in the way she moves attracts me like no other lover. Something in the way she woos me. Don't want to leave her now, you know I believe in how. Somewhere in her smile, she knows that I don't need no other lover. something in her style that shows me. Don't want to leave her now, you know I believe in how. You're asking me, will my love grow? I don't know. Around now it may show, and I don't know, I don't know. Something in the thing she shows me. Don't want to leave her now, you know I believe in how. Thank you.
Hey, that's Peter. Well done. That sounded great, Pete.
Thank you.
Folks, you get to enjoy him for a couple more weeks. Colorado Joe.
Testing. 1, 2, 3. All right, this is John Prine's song that I haven't done in a while. Speed of the Sound of Loneliness. You're feeling small. You come home straight and you come home curly. Sometimes you don't come home at all. So what in the world's come over you? What in heaven's name have I done? Broken the speed of the sound of loneliness. You're out there running just to be on the run. Well, I got a heart that burns with a fever. I got a worried and a jealous mind. How can a love that'll last forever get left so far behind? What in the world's come over you? What in heaven's name have I done? Broken the speed of the sound of loneliness. You're out there running just to be on the run. It's a mighty mean and a jealous sorrow. It's crossed the evil line today. How can you ask about tomorrow when we ain't got a word to say? So what in the world's come over you? What in heaven's name have I done? You broken the speed of the sound of loneliness. You're out there running just to be on the run. So what in the world's come over you? What in heaven's name have I done? Broken the speed of the sound of loneliness. You're out there running just to be on the run. You're out there running just to be on the run. Out there running just to be on the run. Out there running just to be on the run. Oh, thank you. All right, this one's Jason Isbell's song called The Last of My Kind. Couldn't be happy in the city at night. Can't see the stars from the neon light. Sidewalk's dirty and the river is worse. Underground trains all run in reverse. Nobody here dance like me. Everybody's clapping on the one and the three. Am I the last of my kind? Am I last of my kind? So many people with so much to do. Winter so cold my hands turn blue. Old man sleeping on the filthy ground. Spend a whole life just walking around. Nobody here seems to care. Walk right past them while they ain't even there. Man, I'm the best of my kind. Am I the last of my kind? Daddy said the river would always take me home. But the river can't take me back in time. Daddy's dead and gone. Miami Farms, a parking lot at a Walton's Five and Dime. Am I the last of my kind? Am I the last of my kind? Tried to go to college, but I didn't belong. Everything I said was either funny or wrong. Laughed in my boots, laughed in my jeans. Laughed when they gave me amphetamines. Left me alone in a bad part of town. 36 hours to come back down. Am I last of my kind? Am I the last of my kind? Mama says God won't give you too much to bear. That might be true in Arkansas, but I'm a long, long way from there. Whole world's an old-fashioned picture in my mind. Am I the last of my kind? Am I the last of my kind? Am I last of my kind? Am I the last of my kind? Thank you. Thank you. Thanks very much.
Really nicely done, Joe. Glad you brought those songs. Colorado Joe, folks. Yeah.
Play this thing.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, put your hands together for the one and only Clydene.
Thank y'all. Oh, sorry. Technology. You got to be smarter than the technology, y'all.
Is this a mulligan?
It's a mulligan. Does that count as one? Does that count as one?
No, it's $5. Mulligans are $5. Keep it going.
Thank you.
I was going to sing half of that, but I thought, hey, I'm just going to keep going. So you're saying you're glad I didn't sing? Thanks, Glen. You can't win that one. All right, we'll try this one.
That's like that question that you get asked as a man oftentimes.
Does this make my butt?
Does my butt look big in these jeans? There's no way to win.
You can't
That's
win
a question
it.
You should just not pay it.
Try.
You didn't hear it. Just right? What Lincoln said back there.
We'll try that one. And take a deep breath.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, that was lovely. That's Clydene, folks. I always enjoy when the, all kidding aside, I really can't stand these people.
That's why we keep coming back.
I know. It's my penance right here. This is purgatory. It's not hell. It's that in-between place.
Purgatory.
Whatever. But ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, buckaroos and buckarettes, put your hands together for the one and only Beyond Help Band.
I don't know. Yes. Trying out new instrument combos here tonight. This one is for my gal, and my gal just moved to Tennessee with her clan, so we're going to play this in tribute to her. I wrote this when she was here, of course, and you can't make this stuff up. It's all true.
my gal is a project queen, busier than hell. She throws everything in her truck bed beneath her camper shell. She's always buying this or that, a shopper's appetite. I buy things for folks in need, and I think she may be right. Well, my gal's hair is braided, so it doesn't fly away. She laughs this real amazing laugh when she's had enough to say. Her smile is like sunshine in the middle of the night. Spreading sunshine's what I do. I think she may be right. Oh, my gal keeps her CDs in a Ziploc on the floor. The backseat of her pickup seems to be what trash is for. Oh, my gal bought a chainsaw. Now she loves to visit me. She's cleaned up a half of my backyard. It's a lover's fantasy. I got a house full of junk, babe, and it's making me uptight. She says, blow it up and start again. Well, I think she may be right. Oh, my gal keeps her clean clothes in a pillowcase by the door. I don't say what she should do. Ain't that what love is for? My gal uses ice cream in place of half and half. But she always brings a cup for me, and she always makes me laugh. Puts her head on my chest, soft and warm and light. You must be present to win, she says. Well, I think she may be right. Oh, my gal, strong and beautiful, right down to her soul. You watch her play with the grandkids, man, it'll make your spirit whole. Yeah, well, my gal walks on water. She thinks I'm a saint. You take us out fishing, we're like little kids with paint. No one's ever perfect, but we still work out our fights. And she says, love and kindness is never wrong. I think she may be right. Oh, love and kindness never wrong. I think she may be right. Here we go. My gal, thank you very much. And Kay Brayton, let's give a hand to Kay.
Yeah. Sounded great, the Beyond Help Band. You guys sounded great tonight.
Thank you. We'll call you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, buckaroos and buckarinas. Welcome to the Arizona Live Music Cooperative. One of the guys that, had it not been for him, there would be no Arizona Live Music Cooperative. So this would be Cowboy Rex.
Hi, everybody. Yeah, Glen likes to tell the story that he was the fourth guy that I called to see if he wanted to help me do this. But it's not true. He was the third guy. Not really. He was the one and only guy. I can't think of anybody I'd rather do this with, especially all of you all. This is so much fun. All right. Two songs with yodeling in it, okay? So prepare for your yodeling. This one, it's at the end. The other one's in the middle, so. I know you guys are closet yodelers. Yodeling in the car when you're driving. Yodeling in the shower. This is a yodel-safe environment, so you can yodel here. While I was out riding, graveyard shift, midnight till dawn. Moon was as bright as a reading light for a letter from an old friend back home.
He asked me, why do you ride for your money? Why do you rope for short pay? You ain't a-getting nowhere and you're losing your share. Why, you must have gone crazy out there. He said last night he ran on to Ginny. She's married, has a good life. Boy, you sure missed the track when you never come back. She's a perfect professional's wife. But she asked him, why does he ride for his money? Why does he rope for short pay? He ain't a-getting nowhere and he's losing his share. Why, he must have gone crazy out there. Oh, but they've never seen the northern lights, follow the hawk on the wing, or seen the spring break out on the great divide. No, and they've never heard old Camp Cookie sing. I read up the last of my letter, then I tore off the stamp for Black Jim. And when Billy rode up to relieve me, he just looked at that letter and grinned. And he said, well, why do they toil for their money? Why do they work for short pay? They ain't a getting nowhere in their in their share. Why, they all must be crazy out there, because they never slept under the northern lights, followed off on the wing, or seen the spring break out on the great divide. No, and they never heard old Camp Cookie. Ready? This is how he sings. Hello, 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 yeah, hello, yo, hello, yeah, hello.
All right. This is one of my own compositions. I made this one up all by myself. This is one of the songs that I wrote a long, long time ago, and then it came true. It wasn't true when I wrote it, but then it came true. Those of you who know me well know that I have a bunkhouse, what I call the bunkhouse up in Strawberry, Arizona. And it's 6,000 feet and snows 18 inches two or three times a year and big ponderosa pines and all that stuff. So that's what this is about. Beneath the pines on a mountainside, that's where I'll make my home. where nature's beauty fills my heart and I can be alone. I'll have no covers, I don't care, no pillow for my head. Beneath the pines on the mountainside, that's where I'll make my bed. Well, up in the mountains that I love is beauty unsurpassed. Sparkling lakes and meadows green I know are going to last. Amid this world of changing tunes, nature sings her song. Beneath the pines on the mountainside, I've learned to sing along. Here we go. Play. Oh, yeah. Lay. Oh, yeah. Everybody. Lay. Oh, yeah. Lay. Oh, when I die, please bury me beneath the forest floor, so I can go back into the earth and live on evermore. My bones will go to feed wildflowers that fed my soul at times, and someday from my heart will grow a ponderosa pine. Beneath the pines on the mountainside, that's where I'll make my home, where nature's beauty fills my heart and I can be alone. I'll have no comfort, I don't care, no pillow for my head. Beneath the pines on the mountainside, that's where I'll make my bed. Beneath the pines on the mountainside, that's where I'll make
Cowboy Rex, that sounded great. Much yodeling in the house. Yeah, it's a Marshall Tucker song. Station, Lord, don't care where it goes. Gonna climb a mountain, highest mountain, Lord. Jump off, nobody gonna know. Can't you see? Can't you see what that woman, Lord, been doing to me? Can't you see? Can't you see what that woman, Lord, been doing to me? Find me holding a wall. I'm gonna
crawl inside and die. Come a lady man, mean old woman, Lord, never told me goodbye. Can't you see? What that woman, Lord, been doing to me? Can't you see? Can't you see? What that woman, Lord, been doing to me? Buy a ticket now, far as I can. Ain't never coming back. Ride me a southbound, all the way to Georgia now, till the train run out of track. Can't you see? Now what that woman been doing to me? Can't you see? Whoa, can't you see what that woman been doing to me? Take us home, Clydene. Clydene, Balke. Another traveling song. It's one about this part of the world. You ready? Getting ready? The only reason I have her up here is because I still want a job. So it's a little George song. Moving.
by the wind, robbed by the sleet, had my head stove in, still on my feet, and I'm still willing. Smuggled some smokes and folks from Mexico, born by the sun every time I go to Mexico, and I'm still in from Tucson to Tucumcare, Tehachapi to Tonopah, driven every kind of rig that's ever been made, driven the back road so I wouldn't get weighed. And if you give me weed, white sand wine, you show me a sign, I'll be a willing, moving. That sounded great. Clydene Balke, folks. Thank you very, very much. On we go. Thanks, Clydene. That sounded great. Folks, welcome Doug to the Arizona Live Music Cooperative.
Thank you. Okay, speaking of the Muggy on Rim, this song was inspired by kind of a small valley up there that I frequent. It's actually, there was snow there just a few days ago. And so that foretells a good strong forest this year, and really in about a couple of weeks there'll be some ferns starting to grow, and in this valley there's in between the ponderosa pines there's a lot of ferns. In about 2 months there will be fern, they'll be up about waist high. A sea of ferns in the valley. So the picture is, it's about 5-6 o'clock in the evening. The sunlight is starting to get near horizontal, filtering through the ponderosa pines onto the sea of ferns below. The sea of ferns. Thank you. This is a song that you know, but unless you've heard me play it, you probably haven't heard it on a Native American flute.
Nice job, Doug. What a beautiful sounding instrument that is. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together and welcome Philip to the Arizona Live Music Cooperative.
All right. Well, this first song, you know, there's a tradition in folk songs, and you never really hear it here, but the tradition is you write something funny. I mean, so the song is funny now, but when I wrote it like 30 years ago, it wasn't that funny. It's about a young boy looking at all the pictures in People magazine of all the movie stars and wondering which one will take care of him. And so it's called Uma's Boyfriend. Thank you. Don't wanna be known as Uma's boyfriend. Don't wanna be known as Uma's boyfriend. Don't wanna be known as Uma's boyfriend, but I wouldn't mind being Uma's boyfriend. Don't wanna be known as Jen's boyfriend. Don't wanna be known as Mr. Aniston. Could have scored me a backstage pass to friends. I wouldn't mind being Jen's boyfriend. Boy toy. Unemployed, don't want to be known as Julia's boyfriend. Too high maintenance, too much to tend. Besides, she might run away in the end. I wouldn't mind being Julia's boyfriend. Don't want to be known as J-Lo's boyfriend. Look what she did to that fella named Ben. P. Diddy coming round again, but I wouldn't mind being J-Lo's boyfriend. Angelina Jolie, she's the woman for me. I could find my way home, stay away from the foam. Angelina Jolie, Angelina Jolie, baby, can't you see? I'd never leave you alone. I ain't no Billy Bob clone. Angelina Jolie. I don't want to be known as Sandra's boyfriend. I hear she salsas, I hear she bends like a pretzel all twisted from end to end. I wouldn't mind being Sandra's boyfriend. Don't want to be known as Meg's boyfriend. I could put up with the stardom and the college in. I would have liked to known her way back when. Wouldn't mind being her boyfriend. Drew Barrymore, you're either 5 or 4. You were friends with E.T., you're as cute as can be. Drew Barrymore. Hey, but Drew Barrymore, you're not 5 anymore. You're so sexy you kill, you're Charlie's angel. Drew Barrymore. Boy toy. Unemployed, don't wanna be known as Hallie's boyfriend. 007 Dennis in any trouble with men, I'll be there to be a defend. Wouldn't mind being Hallie's boyfriend. Don't wanna be known as Uma's boyfriend. Don't wanna be known as Uma's boyfriend. Don't wanna be known. I wouldn't mind being Uma's boyfriend. Boyfriend, wouldn't mind being Uma's boyfriend. So that's a hard song for me to play. I screwed it up, sorry. Anyway, everybody played such great covers tonight. 3 were played tonight that I was going to play, so I'll play something else. Since my fingers aren't working, I'll just strum. I had a friend who was a big baseball player back in high school. He could throw that speedball by ya, make you feel like a fool. Saw me the other day at this roadside bar. I'm walking in, he was walking out. Had a few drinks,
All he kept saying and all he kept talking about, glory days. Oh, they pass you by, glory days. In the wake of a young girl's eyes, glory days, glory days. There's a girl, she lives up the block. Back in school, she could turn all the boys' heads. Friday, I'd stop by to have a few drinks after she put the kids to bed. She and her husband, Bobby, well, they broke up. Must be 2 years gone by. We just sit around talking about the old days. She says when she feels like crying, she starts laughing about glory days. Oh, they pass you by, glory days. In a wink of a young girl's eyes, glory days, glory days. Think I'll go down to the well tonight. I'm gonna drink till I get my fill. When I get older, I hope I'm not talking about it, but I probably will. Just sitting back, trying to recapture a little of the gloria. Well, time slips away and leaves you with nothing but boring stories of glory days. Oh, they pass you by, glory days. In the wake of a young girl's eyes, glory days, glory days.
Wow, great set, Philip. Let's hear it for Philip one more time. That was really nice. I think we got everything we need. Ladies and gentlemen, Jammin' Jerry and Olyn Wayne.
Take me back to Tulsa. I'm too young to marry. Take me back to Tulsa. I'm too young to marry. Oh, where's that gal with the red dress on? Some folks call her Dinah. Stole my heart away from me way down in Arizona. Oh, little bee sucks a blossom, big bee gets the honey. We all picking cotton just to get some money. Oh, walk and talk to Susie. 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 Oh, I went down to the railroad, laid my head upon the track. Thought about that gal of mine and gradually brought it back. Oh, take me back to Tulsa. I'm too young to marry. Take me back to Tulsa. I'm too young to marry. Oh, where's that gal with the red dress on? Some folk call her Dinah. Stole my heart away from me way down in Arizona. We always wear a great big smile, never do look sour. Travel all the country, playing by the hour. Oh, take me back to Tulsa. I'm too young to marry. Take me back to Tulsa. I'm too young to marry. Where's that gal with the red dress on? Some folk call her Dinah. Stole my heart away from me way down in Arizona. Take me back to Tulsa, I'm too young to marry. Take me back to Tulsa, I'm too young to marry. Take me back to Tulsa, thank you all.
Hey, Jerry.
Yo.
Yo. You know why Italians don't like Jehovah's Witnesses?
No.
Italians don't like no witnesses. So you like my new hat? I pulled it out of a rabbit. Ooh. Thought I'd wear it tonight. Super bunny. Okay. I'm filling in the time while he finds his page.
I was dancing with my darling to the Tennessee waltz when an old friend I happened to see introduced him to my loved one while they were dancing. My friend stole my sweetheart from me. I remember that night and the Tennessee waltz. Now I know just how much I have lost. Yes, I lost my little darling the night they were playing the beautiful Tennessee waltz. I was dancing with my darling to the Tennessee waltz when an old friend I happened to see. That'll be one mulligan. I was dancing with my darling to the Tennessee waltz when an old friend I happened to see introduced him to my loved one while they were dancing. My friend stole my sweetheart from me. I remember that night and the Tennessee waltz. Now I know just how much I have lost. Yes, I lost my little darling the night they were playing the beautiful Tennessee. Tennessee Waltz.
Jammin' Jerry.
Thank y'all, thank y'all. And about that, letting someone dance with your darling, you notice Olyn is always dancing with the different women around here, so you gotta watch out.
Especially when he's wearing that hat.
Yeah.
Nice job, Jammin' Jerry and Olyn. Yeah, yeah. All right. So folks, welcome to the Arizona Live Music Cooperative, Mr. Kevin Brennan.
I went down to 7-Eleven. Man said, what you need? I said, give me a roll of duct tape and a case of NyQuil, please. Give me a bottle of NyQuil. Sleep my body needs analgesic, decongestant with an antihistamine. Now I take only as directed, don't exceed the proper dose. Keep out of reach of children, keep that book cabinet closed. Now give me a bottle of NyQuil, rest will sleep my body needs analgesic, decongestant with an antihistamine. Call me a NyQuil junkie, and I don't know what that means, but I just can't be satisfied till my tongue is green. Give me a bottle of NyQuil, that's what sleep my body needs. Analgesic, decongestant with an antihistamine. Press will sleep my body needs with an analgesic decongestant, an antihistamine. Don't exceed it like the ghost. You gotta read your children and keep that back cabinet closed. I had to find something else that was funny, so. I mean, that's the funny part about doing this gig, right? All right, now, how does that go, left hand? Alternative. Little Jimmy Cox. I lived the life of a millionaire. Spent all my money, now I didn't have any cares. Had my friends out for a mighty good time. I bootleg liquor, champagne and wine. I began to fall so low. Lost all my good friends, I don't know where to go. If I get my hands on a dollar again, I'll hang on to that old eel grin. Because nobody knows you when you're down and out. In your pocket there's not one penny. As for friends, you ain't got any. When you get back on your feet again, everybody wants to be your long lost friend. I said it straight now, out and down. Nobody knows you when you're down and out. There's not one penny. As for friends, you'd be grateful for any. When you get back on your feet again, everybody wants to be your long lost friend. I said it straight now, out and down. Nobody knows you, you're down and out.
Yo. Mr. Kevin Brennan.
Thank you.
Thank you. That sounded great, Kevin.
One, two, three.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Arizona Live Music Cooperative, Mr. Olyn Wayne.
Help me out. An original. Get your degree from your local community college and see if it's all it's cracked up to be, work like a bee.
in your community to make your hive as sweet a hive as any eyes will ever see. Just be yourself instead of somebody else, and don't wreck your health trying to gain a little wealth and then spend the wealth trying to buy back a little health, because it doesn't help. We must be better to ourselves, won't you agree? Then the musicians kicking around a while. Won't you agree? In our society, it's grown to be another form of slavery, and that shouldn't be. But as for me, I'm breaking free and cordially inviting all of y'all, come along with me. Just be yourself instead of somebody else, and don't wreck your health trying to gain a little wealth and then spend the wealth trying to buy back a little health, because it don't help. We must be better to ourselves, don't you agree with me? Or won't you agree with me? Won't you agree? And this is a song that I didn't write, and I don't know who wrote it, but I like it, so I'm going to do it. Well, I told all my troubles goodbye. Goodbye to each tear and each sigh. This world where I roam cannot be my home. Bound for that home in the sky. Oh, I walk and I talk with my Lord. I feast every day on his word. Heaven is near and I just can't stay here. Goodbye, world, goodbye. Now don't you weep for me when I'm gone, 'cause I won't have to leave here alone. And when I hear that last trumpet sound, you know my feet won't stay here on the ground. I'm gonna rise with a shout, gonna fly. I'm gonna take to the sky. Yeah, you know heaven is near, and I just can't stay here. Goodbye, world, goodbye. I won't have those blues anymore when I step across to that shore. And I'll never pine because I'll leave them behind, heartaches and tears evermore. Well, a day may be two and then goodbye. Tomorrow I'll rise up and fly. You know heaven is near and I just can't stay here. Goodbye, world, goodbye. Oh, but don't you weep for me when I'm gone, 'cause I won't have to stay here all alone. And when I hear that last trumpet sound, my feet won't stay here on the ground. I'm gonna rise with a shout, gonna fly. I'm gonna reach the Lord in the sky. You know heaven is near and I just can't stay here. Goodbye, world, goodbye. Goodbye, world, goodbye.
Hey, nice job, Olyn Wayne. That sounded great. Loved them both. Thank you, Olyn. Well, that sounds mighty nice, Billy.
Yeah, probably not quite in tune. I like it. Anyway, this song, only song I wrote overseas during the Vietnam era. To kind of give you an introduction, it was when I first got stationed there, it was at battalion headquarters at the 1st Cav, 1st 21st Artillery. Did a couple recon missions, the liaison captain, but he stuck me on a fire base for 7 months or the rest of my tour over there. And anyway, this song, I kind of, in artillery, we're out there protecting the infantry, and unfortunately they used to call them grunts, but I'm sorry, 11 Bravos out there in the jungle. And I wrote this song just trying to figure out, I wonder what they go through, you know, every day, morning, noon, and night. And this song is kind of dedicated to the Vietnam vets, 11 Bravos in particular, served out there in the war in Vietnam in the jungles. And it's called I Don't Know When. Down on my back, now I try to justify this wall. I don't like war, I never will. In this one won't prevail anymore. And I don't believe in dying for something that I just don't. My thoughts, and I drift back home to you, to your arms, in all your charms. In the love I need so much, and there's just no point in remembering
again.
Well, I don't know when. Thanks, John. You're welcome, sir. Thank you for your service. Thank you. This is another original. This is one I wrote for my wife. I used to travel around a lot, unfortunately, and worked out of an office in Los Angeles, just north of Brentwood. A lot of movie stars walking around out there. I know my wife, Elizabeth, unfortunately, she passed back in February. But you got the biggest kick out of seeing Herb Albert from the Tijuana Brass. And but at any rate, I wrote this song because I was missing her quite a bit. And I was stationed out in L.A. And the song is called Stranded in L.A. And it's a cruel, cruel world out there in the night. You can lose your soul or a life in the fight. So don't walk away, don't leave me alone. Don't run away and leave me standing, stranded in L.A. L.A.'s an only a town, and there's no place to hide. It should bring you down, take you for a ride. So don't walk away, don't leave me alone. Don't run away and leave me standing, stranded. Thank you.
Nicely done, Billy Cage. Yeah, fantastic, Billy. Thank you. That sounded great.
Thank you, Glen. Appreciate it, guys. Thank you.
Well done. All right, folks, welcome to the stage tonight on Enchiladas, Ashley Doty.
Thank you. I'm going to sing an original called Plain to See. Kept an eye real close through the times you chose on your convenience. It passed me by so low that I didn't even know, but I should have seen it. Yeah, I should have. Like a train on the highway, it ain't exactly my way, but it got you from point A to B. Didn't matter how it was achieved, but now you say it was all game. Don't complain, I'm the one blame. How could you not have seen it was all so I was blind. It's not my fault I couldn't get you off my mind. You come and go when you want. Now your name brings me nothing but a home. 'Cause I didn't see it coming. Like a train on a highway, it ain't exactly my way, but it got you from point A to B. Didn't matter how it was achieved. Now you say it was all game. Don't complain, I don't wanna blame. How could you not have seen it was so, so plain to see? But it ain't plain to see when you don't pay covering so strategically, it ain't plain to see. Thank you. And then I'm going to sing a cover song. I decided on... Grandpa by the Judds. The good old days. Sometimes it feels like this world's gone crazy. And Grandpa, take me back to yesterday, when line between right and wrong didn't seem so hazy. Did lovers really fall in love to stay? Stand beside each other, calm and made. Was a promise really something people care? Not just something they would say. Did families really bow their heads to pray? Did daddies really never go away? Whoa, whoa, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days. Everything is changing fast. We call it progress, but I just don't know. And Grandpa, let's wander back into the past. Then paint me a picture of long ago. Did lovers really fall in love to say, stand beside each other, come with me? Was a promise really something people kept? Not just something they would say, make them forget? Did families really bow their heads to pray? Did daddies never go away? Whoa, whoa, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days. Oh, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days.
Really nice set. That's Ashley, folks. That sounded great.
Thank you.
Gus misses you back there, it seemed. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Debbie J. Yeah.
Thank you. So since I'm last, I don't like spoken word to be last at nights like this, but then I did want to share this with you. So it's a story, but it's not quite a bedtime story, and I hope that I can read it because it's a dramatic reading and I'm having lighting issues. This is from C.S. Lewis, The Great Divorce. It's partway through. Some travelers have just departed or deboarded. Do you deboard a bus? And they are in a different place. And they're finding that they're not, well, we'll just go from there. So, yeah. And I began to look about. In spite of his reference to a crowd, the solitude was so vast that I could hardly notice the knot of phantoms in the foreground. Greenness and light had almost swallowed them up. Long after that, I saw people coming to meet us. Because they were bright, I saw them while they were still very distant. And at first, I did not know that they were people at all. Mile after mile after mile, they drew nearer. The earth shook under their tread as their strong feet sank into the wet turf. A tiny haze and a sweet smell went up where they had crushed the grass and scattered the dew. Some were naked, some robed, but the naked ones did not seem less adorned, and the robes did not disguise in those who wore them the massive grandeur of muscle and the radiant smoothness of flesh. Some were bearded, but no one in that company struck me as being of a particular age. One gets glimpses, even in our country, of that which is ageless, heavy thought in the face of an infant and frolic childhood in the face of a very old man. Here, it was all like that. They came on steadily. I did not entirely like it. Two of the ghosts screamed and ran for the bus. The rest of us huddled closer to one another as the solid people came nearer. Still, I noticed that they were moving with order and determination, as though each of them has marked his man in our shadowy company. They're going to be affecting scenes, I said to myself. Perhaps it would not be right to look on. With that, I sidled away on some vague pretext of doing a little exploring. A grove of huge cedars to my right seemed attractive, and I entered it. Walking proved difficult. The grass, hard as diamonds to my unsubstantial feet, made me feel as if I were walking on wrinkled rock, and I suffered pains like those of the mermaid in Hans Andersen. A bird ran across in front of me, and I envied it. It belonged to that country and was as real as the grass. It could bend the stalks and spatter itself with the dew. Almost at once, I was followed by what I have called the big man. To speak more accurately, the big ghost. He, in his turn, was followed by one of the bright people. "Don't you know me?" he shouted to the ghost. I found it impossible not to turn and attend. The face of the solid spirit, he was one of those that wore a robe, made me want to dance. It was so jocund, so established in its youthfulness. "Well, I'm damned," said the ghost. "I wouldn't have believed it. It's a fair knockout. It isn't right, Len. You know what? What about poor Jack? You look pretty pleased with yourself, but what I say is, what about poor Jack?" "He is here," said the other. "You will meet him soon if you stay." "But you murdered him." "Of course I did. It is all right now." "All right, is it? All right for you, you mean. But what about the poor chap himself, laying all cold and dead?" "But he isn't. I have told you, you will meet him soon. He sent you his love." "What I'd like to understand," said the ghost, "is what you're here for. Please just punch you, a bloody murderer, while I've been walking the streets down there and living in a place like a pigsty all these years." "That is a little hard to understand at first, but it is all over now. You will be pleased about it presently. Till then, there is no need to talk about it. No need to bother about it. Aren't you ashamed of yourself?" "No, not as you mean. I do not look at myself. I have given up myself. I had to, you know, after the murder. That was what it did for me. And that was how everything began." "Personally," said the big ghost, with an emphasis which contradicted the ordinary meaning of the word. "Personally, I'd have thought you and I ought to be the other way around. That's my personal opinion." "Very likely we soon shall be," said the other, "if you'll stop thinking about it." "Look at me now," said the ghost, slapping its chest, but the slap made no noise. "I gone straight all my life. I don't say I was a religious man, and I don't say I had no faults. Far from it. But I done my best all my life. See, I done my best by everyone. I done my best, and that's the sort of chap I was. I never asked for anything that wasn't mine by rights. If I wanted a drink, I paid for it. And if I took my wages, I done my job. See, that's the way I was, and I don't care who knows it." "It would be much better not to go on about that now." What's going on? Who's going on? I'm not arguing. I'm just telling you the sort of chap I was. See, I'm asking for nothing but my rights. You may think you can put me down because you're dressed up like that, which you weren't when you worked for me. And I'm only a poor man, but I got to have my rights, same as you, see? No, it's not so bad as that. I haven't got my rights, or I should not be here. You will not get yours either. You'll get something far better. Never fear. That's just what I say. I haven't got my rights. I always done my best, and I never done anything wrong, and what I don't see is why I should be put below a bloody murderer like you. Who knows whether you will be? Only be happy and come with me. Well, what do you want to keep on arguing for? I'm only telling you the sort of chap I am. I want my rights. I'm not asking for anybody's bleeding charity. Then do, at once, ask for the bleeding charity. Everything is here for the asking, and nothing can be bought. That might be very well for you, I dare say. If they choose to let in a bloody murderer, all because he makes a poor mouth at the last moment, That's their lookout. But I don't see myself going in the same boat. You see? Why? Why should I? I don't want charity. I'm a decent man, and if I had my rights, I'd have been here long ago, and you could tell them I said so. The other shook his head. You can never do it like that, he said. Your feet will never grow hard enough to walk out on our grass that way. You'd be tired out before we get to the mountains. And it isn't exactly true, you know, about you being... Mirth danced in his eyes as he said it. Well, what isn't true? Asked the ghost. You weren't a decent man, and you didn't do your best. We, none of us were, and none of us did. Lord bless you. It doesn't matter. There's no need to go into it all now. You, gasped the ghost. You have the face to tell me I wasn't a decent chap. Of course. Must I go into all of that? I will tell you one thing to begin with. Murdering old Jack wasn't the worst thing I did. That was the work of a moment, and I was half mad when I did it. But I murdered you in my heart, deliberately. For years, I used to lie awake at nights thinking what I'd do to you if I ever got the chance. That is why I have been sent to you now, to ask your forgiveness and to be your servant as long as you need one, and longer if it pleases you. I was the worst, but all the men who worked under you felt the same. You made it hard for us, you know, and you made it hard for your wife and for your children. You don't mind your own business, young man, said the ghost. None of your lips, see? Because I'm not taking any impudence from you about my private affairs. There are no private affairs, said the other. And I'll tell you another thing, said the ghost. You can clear it off, see? You're not wanted. I may be only a poor man, but I'm not making pals with a murderer, let alone taking lessons from him. Made it hard for you. Like, I did. If I had you back there, I'd show you what work is. Come, show me now, said the other with laughter in his voice. It will be joy going to the mountains, but there will be plenty of work. You don't suppose I'd go with you? Don't refuse. You'll never get there alone. And I am the one who was sent to you. So that's the trick, is it? Shouted the ghost, outwardly bitter. And yet, I thought there was a kind of triumph in his voice. It had been entreated. It could make a refusal. And this seemed to it a kind of advantage. I thought there'd be some damn nonsense. It's all a click, all a bloody click. Tell them I'm not coming, see? I'd rather be damned than go along with you. I came here to get my rights, see? Not to go sniveling along on charity, tied onto your apron strings. If they're too fine to have me without you, I'll go home. It was almost happy now that it could, in a sense, threaten. That's what I'll do, it repeated. I'll go home. I didn't come here to be treated like a dog. I'll go home. That's what I'll do. Damn and blast the whole pack of you. In the end, still grumbling, but whimpering also a little as it picked its way over the sharp grass, it made off. Thank you.
Debbie J, thank you. And thank all of you. It was a great, great night. We will be back right here next week. Please travel safely. Love all you guys. And thank you so much for being part of the Arizona Live Music Cooperative.